everyone, welcome to my channel. So in today's video, I created this makeup look right here. So yesterday I had worn this makeup look for some video and I posted some Instagram stories and I got so many requests to make a video on this look. And honestly, I've done this look so many times except for a few little different things. And my wedding makeup look almost looks the same except for a couple of things. Anyway, I just sort of making this makeup look because you guys like my simple glam makeup looks. So here it is and I hope you enjoy it. And now let's get started. So first let me just put this headband so that our hair doesn't come in the way. And it's really cloudy, so I'm sorry if the light is not proper today. It's about to rain, so I should finish this video before the rain starts. First I'll be spritzing some Fix Plus all over my face. By the way, I've also worn lenses. So these are from Fresh Look in the color gray. I also have the color Pure Hazel, so I like Pure Hazel more than gray. Next I'll be using this Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Face Base. It started raining. So I'm just applying it all over my face. While my face was damp, so my face was already damp with the MAC Fix Plus, right? So it just absorbs better and gives more hydration according to me. Next I'll be using the MAC Strobe Cream and applying it mostly here. I want to apply it all over my face, but I have some breakouts, so I don't want to emphasize them, just on the highest points and the non-breakout areas basically. For the foundation, I'll be mixing these two foundations, both are by K Beauty in different shades. One is in the shade 120 by light and 170 by tan. So the mixture of this is perfect for my skin tone. And I'm taking my Pack Beauty Blender, and with the beauty blender only I'm mixing these two shades. I don't want to dirty my hands, and just first spread it all over my face and then blend it out. This foundation doesn't give much coverage, so I'll be using my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Pure Beige and applying where I need more coverage. I usually do this before the foundation, but today I forgot. But anyway, it doesn't matter. And again, blending it with the beauty blender. Now for a little bit more coverage, I'll be using the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade Honey and just applying little bit on the eyes and some on the spots as well. It doesn't give a lot of coverage, but I really like the shade of this one. It's similar to Pure Beige, and whatever's left on it I'm also applying on my eyelids. Now to brighten the center of my face, I'm again using the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, but this is in the shade Sand. This is really light for me, so I'll be applying a little bit over here under my eyes, on my forehead, a little bit on my nose and chin. I've been really enjoying highlighting these days. And now lightly blend it out. So I'm just lightly pouncing the beauty blender. Don't dab too hard. And while blending, I'm looking up so that it's stretched and it's applied evenly. So now that our concealer, foundation, everything is done, I'm going to let it dry for some time, because if you directly apply powder on wet skin, like wet concealer skin, it will become like a paste. You remember Ross puts powder on top of lotion? Yeah, that's what is going to happen, and it's going to crease. So we're just going to let it dry for a few seconds. And by dry I mean like set by itself, because they do set by themselves, like they don't look wet forever. So I'm just gonna wait for them to set. Can you see the wetness? And while it's setting by itself, don't touch anywhere, because if you touch then it's gonna create those dents and you'll have to do it again. So just don't touch your face. If you feel your concealer is creasing, just use a beauty blender and lightly go over it, like just lightly dab it, so that whatever creases or lines are there, they are just evened out. You can also use a brush, but use very little pressure. Can you see now it has started creasing because of my lower lashes? So I'm just lightly going to press it while looking up. Focus, Vibha. Now to set the concealer, I'm using the Huda Beauty Easy Bake in the shade Sugar Cookie. I'm going to take this much, look up, and pack it. Like baking only, but I'm not gonna keep it for that long. As soon as I'm done applying it, I'm gonna dust it off. So wherever I've applied the concealer, I'm just gonna apply the powder there. After I'm done, I'm just dusting off the powder using a fluffy brush. I'll just tie my hair because it's really hot. Putting some powder here because I'm sweating. So now my face is looking ekdam se flat because there's no dimension to it. So let's add some dimension. So for that I'm using this Bahama Mama bronzer. This is a ProArt PF 12 brush. Just taking a little bit, dusting off the excess and applying it as a contour and just blend it upwards in circular motions. Applying on my forehead, on the sides also hiding my double chin with it. This one is more on the cool tone side, like I mean it's mostly neutral, the Bahama Mama bronzer, and the Hoola bronzer a little bit towards the warm side, so I want a little bit warmth as well. So I'll be using the Hoola bronzer and applying as a bronzer basically, so that Bahama Mama bronzer was mostly contouring, this is bronzing. So basically applying in the same areas but applying it more on the cheeks, like a blush basically, but not exactly. This added so much dimension. Now I'm going to contour my nose with the Hoola bronzer, drawing on the sides of my nose, blending a little bit with this brush as well. I almost forgot to fill in the eyebrows, so for that I'm using the Sugar Brow Definer, filling in my eyebrows. On top of that, using the NYX Tinted Brow Mascara. I'm looking too sharp right now, like with the contour and really dark eyebrows. I'm just going to take a little bit of powder and just cleaning this up because the bronzer has come down a little bit. For the blush, I'm using the K-Beauty blush in the shade Sugar Candy. It's a really beautiful color. Applying it on my cheeks. On my nose also. Little bit on my chin as well. For the eyeshadow, I'm going to come closer now. So for this, I'm using the K-Beauty eyeshadow palette in the variant Bare Soul. I really love the colors from this palette. Usually, I don't like ekdam se neutral or cool tone shades. You know, those cool tone browns. But this one is not like those cool tone browns. This one is pretty neutral and little bit, you know, it has this burnt and little bit warm tones. So which I really love. I don't like ekdam se cool tone looks. So I'm using this brush. This is from PAC in the number 273. And I'm using this shade called Toast. These days I just end up using just single brush for the entire eye look. Because I end up just filling in my entire lids with just one color. So I'll just apply this all over my lid. By the way, after applying on the eyelids, I'm also blending it in my crease so that it's like diffused. Also applying it under my eyes with the same brush. For the next shade, I'm using this shade called Tan. Just a little bit and tap off the excess and applying it on my outer V and then blending it in my crease. Also applying it under my eyes. Next, I'm using the Huda Beauty Desert Dusk palette and mixing these two shades, Amber and Saffron. You don't really have to use these different kind of shades. I'm just using them because I have that many shades and I end up not even using it. So might as well use everything. Again, applying it in my outer V and blending it. It just added a little bit more warmth and a little bit of pink or red. Again, under my eyes. By the way, I'm using the same brush, okay, for everything. And now when there's barely anything on the brush, again going over everything so that it's nicely blended. There are no harsh colors. Next, I'm using the Huda Beauty Desert Dusk palette and mixing these two shades, Moon Dust and Bubbly. And I'm taking this tiny brush. This is the Vega Lip Filler. Applying it in my inner third, kind of like a cut crease, but very subtle. Also applying in my inner corner and a little bit under my eyes as well. just in the beginning, so that like the center of my eyes are like more open. I'm just patting on the edges so that the two colors are blended properly. Now I'll be curling my lashes using the Colourbar eyelash curler. Next I'm using this Sugar mascara. This always happens. Now I'm gonna use this pack M75 lashes. I've cut them into half because these days I'm just applying half of the lash on the outer side. So what I do is I just take this half lash and apply only on the outer side. So after applying the glue, I let it dry, okay, because the glue should be tacky. So after applying the lash, press both of them together and also push it so that it's stuck to my eyelids and also blended with my natural lash properly. So pressing and pushing. So I'll just repeat the same step on this eye and be right back. So I'm back with the lashes. Just gonna take this spoolie and remove this mascara spot. Next, I'm gonna use this black Kajal by Plum and applying it on my upper waterline. Just tight lining it. And now I'm gonna take this nude Kajal by Wet n Wild and applying on my lower lash line. Sorry, lower waterline. These lashes might look a little weird on me because my rest of the lashes are so small and suddenly like very long lash. For the lipstick, I'm lining my lips with the Nykaa lip pencil in the shade Pillow Fight. Slightly overlining. Fill in my entire lip. Next, I'm using the Huda Beauty Liquid Matte in the shade Trendsetter. Also using this Huda Beauty Liquid Matte in the shade Bombshell in the center. Now I'll be spritzing my face with the MAC 6 Plus again. Just to melt everything together and also for my highlighter. Because when you apply highlighter on slightly damp skin, it just pops even more. Let it dry, okay? It should be the perfect amount of damp, like not too damp, not too wet, and not too dry either. So just gonna let it dry. Okay, now can you see it's not too dry? There's a little bit of moistness. So I'll be using this highlighter from Becca, Champagne Pop. Such a beautiful highlighter. Using this NYX brush. So yes, we are done, dunny dunny. My hair is slightly damp because I did not wear a shower cap while having bath. Wearing some hoops. Hoops look so good. They suddenly take your look from 5 to 10. In my case, 10 to 10. Just kidding. Yeah. Let me also apply some highlighter over here on my collarbones. It's not like you're gonna see it, but still. So this is the finished look. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. I upload new videos every Saturday. When you click on the thumbs up button, it's just an acknowledgement from your side that you're liking my content, and it also motivates me to do better. And when you subscribe to my channel, it just helps my channel to grow. So if you think I deserve it, please subscribe to my channel. It's completely free. And today's comment shout out goes to Savari. Thank you so much for your comment. And yeah, that's it for this video, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.